Well, hello there and welcome to the Biz Week of FIRST. Well, this is the first Biz Week for the year 2012 and also marks the first week of trading for the Nairobi Securities Exchange and of course the first school term for the year 2012. We promise to keep you abreast with what is happening in the world of business. I am O'Brien Kimani. Many thanks for joining us and we are coming to you from the ever busy shopping mall of Sarit Center here in the suburbs of Westland. And I got some comments here from Sylvia Delap, Jackson and David all the way in Malindi. You are saying thank you Biz Week for updating us on what is happening in the business world. Sylvia, Jackson and David, we promise to keep you posted on what is happening in the world of business. Many thanks indeed for watching this first episode of Biz Week. I am O'Brien Kimani. Well, the information and communication sector continued with its growth trajectory in the year 2011, becoming the agent of growth for the economy. From mobile phone penetration to internet connectivity, the industry registered impressive growth this year. Manufacturers outdid each other with new and trendy gizmos from the iPads to iPhones. Users were spoiled for choice. And as Kamau Bote reports, the year ahead may not be different because manufacturers of tech gizmos are even promising more devices.
Spilling over from the year 2010, the price wars in the voice segment of telecommunication were high notch, fueled by new entrants into the market, Bharti and Esa, both Indian companies that are still trying to consolidate their hold locally. There were also casualties in both sides, with Airtel CEO Rene Meza throwing in the towel and heading to Tanzanian giant Vodacom to be replaced by Shivan Bargava. Your sister company, Aegis Services Kenya Limited, went under as you terminated its contract with the company, forcing Aegis out of the Kenyan market for the cost-effective Horizon Contact Center to handle its call center services, with affected employees being asked to reapply for their positions. You, however, managed to cause ripples in the industry in 2011 after the company announced that its subscribers would now call for free when making you-to-you links from 6 in the morning to 6 in the evening, effectively making it the most enticing on-net tariff network. The competition also saw giant provider Safaricom, that had for long complained of the underpriced voice calls in the country, cut its rates to as low as 2 shillings per minute. Another indirect casualty in the price wars was the Director General of the Communication Commission of Kenya. Under his reign, Njoroge drove the industry to one of the cheapest call rates in the region and the only country applying the pure lyric model. His reappointment was quashed by the High Court after the Consumer Federation of Kenya argued that the board and the Minister of Information did not advertise the post in the reappointment, thus did not allow fair competition.
If the great post has anything to do with that, I'll be more than happy because I'll have done my part as DG in CCK.
However, the main casualty of the whole prize was Safaricom, that saw its half-year profits plummet by a massive 48%. Safaricom said the dip was as a direct result of the fierce price wars as well as the harsh operating environment which affected their customers' disposable income.
Rising operational costs across the board, coupled with declining voice revenues as a consequence of the intense price war, has negatively impacted the entire industry.
Another important happening in the year was the broadcast frequency licensing by the regulator that would see all media stations reapply their licenses, failure to which they risk losing the licenses. The order saw the regulator and the media fight each other to the courts, with neither side relinquishing their stand.
We are not going to switch them off immediately because they have a frequency license with us which lasts up to July of every year. And they renewed the frequencies this 2011, 2012. And therefore, come July next year, we are not going to renew. We shall not accept the payments for the frequencies.
Currently, the High Court has stopped the regulator from going ahead and taking over the frequencies, but what will be the end result? Another battle between the government and the media was the allocation of the digital distribution signal to the Chinese-owned Pan-African Media, with the government promising to hand over the last signal to the consortium of the local media in respect to the heavy investment in the industry. Still in the courts, internet provider Kenya Data Networks was sued by cable company Soliton Telmec over unpaid dues accumulating to over 400 million shillings. The move saw the management of KDN rush to assure all shareholders and creditors that the company was stable during the opening of the offices at the Samia Business Park.
With the announcement of a multi-million dollar data center, a multi-million dollar extension of our network through Uganda, and other projects that we've completed in the last weeks, it certainly doesn't look like a company that should or could be wound up.
However, the matter was settled out of court between the two companies, with Soliton Telmec agreeing to withdraw their winding up petition filed against KDN in the High Court of Kenya. Both parties also agreed to withdraw with various applications and appeals arising from the petition. On a brighter ending, the year also saw the largest number of launches in the smartphone industry during the Barcelona Mobile Congress. The year saw a competition to launch both the tablet and the 3D smartphone by all the major players. 2011 also saw the Internet Governance Forum for the first time being held in Nairobi at the United Nations Gigiri Complex.
Most of the security, internet security debate centers around the mobile, because practically every Kenyan has access to mobile.
However, back to the courts, as competition heated up, there were a number of civil cases by companies on breach of patents. Lastly, 2011 also saw the demise of a genius accredited with the transformation of especially the smartphone segment. Apple CEO and co-founder Steve Jobs died on October the 5th, aged 56, after several years of fighting pancreatic cancer.
Well, it is the back-to-school season, and many are suffering from what is loosely referred to as the back-to-school blues. After an expenses-filled holiday, thousands of students and parents are thronging shopping malls for the back-to-school shopping. Now, we interacted with a few students, and this is exactly what they think about the year 2012 to look like, and generally what they think the government should do in order to bring down the cost of living as well as costs of education in this country.
My name is Natalie Tafuma. I'm going to standard 7, and I'm from Loreto Msongari, that school that had a tragedy accident.
Good. So when you look at the cost of living in Kenya now that you come from Zimbabwe, what conclusions do you make?
I think Kenya has a lot of many things that it has, a lot of things, like, for example, it's quite big, more than Zimbabwe, and also Kenya offers a lot, education is higher than the one in Zimbabwe, yeah. And also, you know, here things are affordable more than Zimbabwe, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So when you look at the cost of goods, the products that you have come here to purchase, mm-hmm. do you think they are very high, do you think they are very cheap?
Well, in Zimbabwe we're using US dollars, which is quite high, so when we come here it's quite cheaper than the way in Zimbabwe, so it's cheap.
2011 it was quite high, honestly. Many people had to do with other features which they couldn't, because they couldn't afford to buy a certain items and support their families. But this year I think the government should at least help struggling families, especially those who are trying to pay for their children to go to secondary education, in ways as such as you could give them a grant, a loan perhaps, and yeah, increase the amount of teachers in schools, in secondary schools, because they don't do that anymore. Mm-hmm. It's quite low, and people are struggling, students are struggling to learn. When there's always a strike out, a teacher goes to a strike, the rest go to a strike, and there's no learning, and the students are the ones who suffer the most.
And as for me, I think the government should also think of the less privileged people, not just thinking about themselves, and yeah.
Are you happy with the government, the work it is doing to bring down the cost of living?
Yes, I think they are trying their best, because I don't think it's an easy job to be in the government and leading a big country, because Kenya is a big country.
according to what the government is telling us and it's what it's promising the citizens is that the economy will go down. That's what we all, that's all we are hoping for.
I think the prices are really high, but there are a lot of offers, so I get a wide choice. Yeah, I can choose, depending on the offer, I can choose what suits the price, but relatively they're still high.
If there was one year that goes into history as one of the most volatile for the Kenyan financial sector, it will be the year 2011. And the facts are compelling. From the collapse of the Blue Shield Insurance Company to the historical weakening of the Kenyan shilling, the year 2011 was never on the Kenyan side of the financial sector. But amid the gloom, there were some sectors that bloomed. They marked the return of the Uchumi supermarket back on the Nairobi Stock Exchange. Oh, sorry, the market changed as well to Nairobi Securities Exchange. More details next.
As the first month of the year goes for the stock market, so is the rest of the year. So goes a popular business maxim. And if the saying was to be taken seriously, then it was right for the Nairobi Securities Exchange. From the first week of January, it was evident that tough times awaited the market ahead. The performance of the market this year has been erratic, and the NSE has been marked as one of the worst performers in sub-Saharan Africa in 2011 so far. The NSE 20 share index started the year at over 4,400 points, but dipped below the 4,000 mark by the end of the first quarter, recovering in May, only to drop once again. Today, the index is below the 3,200 mark, and the fall has not halted. Despite much assurance by polished market analysts that the market was undergoing temporary shocks, their predictions never materialized. The poor showing by the market was attributed to continued political uncertainty due to the International Criminal Court cases, coupled with rising oil prices, inflation rates, and the Arab Spring uprisings. All this came and passed, but the market continued with its losing streak. Today, a lot of water has passed under the bridge and the market remains bearish. But the market had some positive news after it partnered with the global indices FTSE of London, thrusting the market on the international radar for foreign investors.
We hope that they will help investors to gauge and measure the performance of their portfolios, as well as acting as a foundation for the creation of index-related products.
They can help provide visibility both inside Kenya, but also internationally, and to just grow the reputation.
An hour away from the market, the performance of the Kenya shilling headlined not only the local dailies, but it captured the attention of the international media. What started as a normal volatility spread to become an issue of national concern when the shilling lost about 25% of its value against the dollar. Despite strong calls to the central bank to intervene and stem the slide, CBK remained defiant and the shilling slid further to hit a low of 127 against the dollar mid-October.
The central bank is pursuing a policy that only they believe in. There is not another person who believes in the central bank's policy.
The gradualism was to try and contain those supply-side measures without hurting growth adversely.
This is when the government put up an albeit late spirited effort to rescue the troubled Kenyan yuan.
The Central Bank of Kenya will continue to monitor closely and indeed, as we did agree, hold regular consultations with commercial banks with a view to identifying early enough emerging issues and taking corrective measures.
Today the shilling has recovered much ground, but it still remains distance away from the levels of 70s it was trading early last year. To stabilize the situation, Central Bank has increased central bank rates to 18% from 5% in January. The year so troubled insurer Blue Shield placed under statutory management by the Insurance Regulatory Authority for inability to honor claims. IRA further barred the insurer from conducting any new businesses and advised existing policyholders to use other underwriters. IRA attributed the firm's woe to its involvement in the public service vehicles insurance business, which has been beset by soaring claims, fraud, and litigation. In the year, Boardroom Rangus also dominated headlines with listed auto dealer CMC Group and Marshals washing their dirty linen in public. Apart from the intense wrangles among directors of CMC that led to the suspension of trading rights of the company shares by the Capital Markets Authority, the company found itself being discussed on the floor of the August House, with legislators demanding to know whether managing director Bill Lee had a valid work permit.
I have with me a document dated 26th of May 2011 from the Immigration Department, original document, Mr. Speaker, which shows that Bill Lee was denied an entry, Mr. Speaker.
Let the trading begin. But one of the most memorable moments of the year in corporate Kenya was when President Mwai Kibaki rang the bell to mark the return of the Uchumi supermarket shares on the NSE after 5 years in the cold. And due to its sterling performance and strong demand among investors, Uchumi Supermarket's stock won the retailer a slot in the price indicative NSE 20 share index. Though the year has been volatile in many aspects, there is a high hope that the year ahead will mark a turning point for the country.
Well, and with that, we wrap up our program for today. Thank you very much for watching the first episode of Biz Week right here on KBC Channel 1. We hope you have not only been entertained, you have been informed as well as educated. I am O'Brien Kimani. We hope to see you again on Wednesday, same time right here on KBC Channel 1. And until then, as I always say, have yourself a profitable week ahead of you.